Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can implement these patterns with the help of C programming. Before starting, if you want to watch more programming related videos, so you can go to the details of this video. So there you will find various links related to programming playlist. So do watch them. Now, first I am going to implement the solution for this pattern. Then I will tell you how easily you can convert that pattern to print this one and this pattern, right? So here you can see we have five different rows. We have five different rows, and these number of rows can be any number. So right now it is five. So user can enter that I want to print 10 rows. User can enter like I want to print 15 rows. So number of rows will be entered by the user. So I am assuming that will be stored inside n variable. So you will use printf and scanf to read that number from the user. So starting from main, I will be using these three variables, int, n, I, and j. Now, inside printf, I'm writing enter number. So this message will be displayed on output screen. And user will provide a number into n variable, right? So n is having how many number of rows you want to print. So let's say n is 5, so we need to print 5 rows. So we need to implement one loop that will repeat 5 times. So for that, I am implementing first for loop. So because I need to iterate this loop 5 times, so that's why I started it from 1, and condition is I less than equals to 5. So it will start from 1 and it will end to 5, so it will repeat 5 times. Then it will repeat first time, so it will print 1, that is one value. Then if it repeats second time, so this loop needs to print 2 digits, that is 2 times, right? So it means inside this loop, we need to implement one more loop that will be printing these digits, right? And that loop will depend upon the value of I, like how many times that loop will repeat. So inside this loop, I'm going to implement one more loop. So here, see the condition. J less than equals to I. So J loop termination condition is dependent upon I. It will iterate as per the value of I. And then you can write J plus plus, right? Now inside this loop, you need to write printf percent D. Now here you can see in each row, we need to print same digit. In each row, we need to print same digit. So if you go to first row, value is 1. If you go to second row, value is 2. Third row, value is 3. So it means we need to print value of I, because I is pointing to the row. So here we can print value of I and we can close this loop, right? After completion of this loop, for new line, you can use this printf. So it will print new line character, that is backslash n, so that cursor will be shifted to new line. Then this for loop will be completed and then main function will be completed. Now I am going to explain the execution cycle of this loop so that you can see how it will be printed. So initially value of I will be 1. Initially value of I will be 1. Check this condition, it is true. Now we will move to this loop. So when condition of outer loop, that is I, is true, then we transfer control to inner loop. Then inner loop will complete its cycle. Then it will come to this printf, and then control will move here. So J is starting from 1. Condition is J less than equals to I. And what is the value of I? It is 1. So this loop will repeat 1 time. And what value it will print? Value of I. So here you can see 1 will be printed 1 time. Then it will complete, printf will print new line, then I plus plus. So this time value of I is 2. This time value of I is 2. And again we are entering into J loop. So So j will begin from 1 and it will move to I. So right now value of I is 2. So how many times this loop will repeat? 2 times, because it is again starting from 1 and it is going to 2. So 2 times it will repeat and 2 times it will print value of I. So see carefully, while we are rotating this loop, so anywhere are we changing the value of I? No, we are not changing value of I anywhere. So inside this loop, value of I will be 2 and that will be printed 2 times. So now I hope you understood why I took I here. After completion of this loop, printf will print new line, then I plus plus will take place. So I will become 3. Again, j will start from 1 and it will move 3 times now because I is 3. So it will repeat 3 times and 3 times I will be printed. So value of I is 3. So 3 times 3 will be printed. So this way, this loop will print the pattern. Right? Now, if I replace this I to j, so this pattern will be printed. Now see how. So again, initially value of I will be 1. It will start from 1, j loop, and move to 1. So j will print 1. So it is quite easy. Then new line, then I plus plus. So I will become 2. So again, j will begin from 1. It will move to 2. And now here you can see we are printing j, not I. So first time j is 1. So in second row, you can see j is printing 1 first. Then j plus plus, so it will become 2 because this time loop will repeat 2 times. So j will become 2 and next time it will print 2 here. Then it will be terminated, new line will be printed, I plus plus. This time value of I is 3. So it means j will repeat 3 times starting from 1 to 3. So j first will print 1, then 2 and then 3. So this time we are printing j because we want every time printing will start from 1 and it will go to that value which is representing the whole. So this way, this change will print the second pattern. Everything will be same except this I will be replaced to j. Right? Now we are going to print this one. So here you can see continuous digits are printed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we can't use I, we can't use j. So we need one more variable, k, and that I am starting from 1. So in place of j, I am going to print k here, and after printing, I am going to increase it by 1 so that next digit will be available. So if you rotate this, so when I will be 1, so this j loop will repeat 1 time, so k will print 1. After printing k, it will become 2. After printing k 1, it will become 2, but j is repeating 1 time, so it will terminate. Then we will move to new line, then I plus plus will take place, so I is 2 now. Then j will repeat 2 times, right? So first time it will print k. So what is the value of k? It is 2. So 2 will be printed and k plus plus will make it to 3. So this time j is repeated only once. So j loop printed value of k, then it is incremented to 3. So this is one rotation. One rotation is more pending. So j again increased its value, check the condition, it is true. Then again k will print. So right now k is 3 and after printing it will become 4. So now two rotations are completed. So 2 and 3 are printed. Then completion of this loop, new line, I plus plus, so I will become 3. So this time j will repeat 3 times. So 3 times k will be printed and 3 times k will be incremented as well. So first we will print k, so last value of k is 4. So it will print 4 and after that it will increment to 5. So printing of k and its increment is completely one rotation of loop. So now we print 5 and increase it to 6. So it is second rotation. Then again print k, that is 6. and increase it to 7. So it is third rotation. So after this third rotation, this J will terminate, new line will print, and I plus plus. So I will become 4 and so on. You can print the rest of the digits. So this way, these three patterns can be printed with the same format. You just need to put I, J, and K values here for this first, second, and third pattern. So I hope you understood how you can print these three patterns with the help of C program. So implement this solution in your laptop so that you can understand how this is working. And if you want to watch more programming related videos, you can open my channel, go to playlist. There I have uploaded more than 1000 videos, so you can watch them. And I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. So thank you for watching this video.